The main protagonist of Fire Emblem Thracia 776, Leif, is finally out, but it seems like good old Reinhardt has stolen the main spotlight. To be honest, Reinhardt is a complete monster, but I got a Leif for myself, so I wanted to make a video about him. Despite how good Reinhardt is on this banner, Leif holds his own and is pretty respectable for an infantry sword unit, in my opinion. His neutral 5-star stats are 40 HP, 32 attack, 38 speed, 30 defense, and 23 resistance. That 38 base speed stands out pretty well, and I think it's one of Leif's main strengths. For natures, I'd highly suggest plus speed with plus attack or plus defense as good secondary options. I think it's okay to drop Leif's HP and resistance, but I'd suggest minus res over minus HP if you can. The most important thing is to hopefully not get minus speed, since that sort of squanders his best stat and will limit your build options the most. Doesn't make him unusable, but 38 base speed is really strong. For a quick stat comparison, Leif has a similar stat line to two of our most popular Myrmidons in the game. Mia is slightly faster but weaker defensively. Ira is very close to Leif's stats, however when we take into account all three units with their unique legendary weapons equipped, things change a little. Leif's light brand only grants plus 3 defense, which is okay but won't help him out offensively. Meanwhile, Mia's Resolute Blade is a woe dao with plus 3 extra might, meaning she's not only faster than Leif, but she hits harder too. Ira's Blade grants her 3 extra speed, putting her above Leif, plus her X to her unique Regno Astro special really puts her over the top in terms of offensive might. Leif's not bad, but Mia and Ira just pack a more powerful punch. For Leif's base kit, he comes with the Light Brand Sword, which I will talk about more in just a bit. His special is Blazing Light, which is okay, but to me the light pattern is a bit more unreliable to hit than other AoE specials. Steady Breath will grant Leif plus 4 speed and defense when initiating, which works pretty well with his high speed and decent defense stat. S-Strength is Leif's unique B skill, and it only works once during a fight. At the start of a turn, it heals Leif to full HP and grants him minus 1s to his special cooldown. For Arena, this is just a Quick and Pulse seal in the B slot, but it has way better effectiveness in PvE modes like Tempest Trials. His C skill is Drive Attack, which is pretty basic, nothing too crazy. Now let's discuss how the light brand works, since it does bring a new type of effect. Besides the extra 3 defense, if Leif's foe's defensive stat is 5 points higher than the resistance stat, then the light brand adds 7 extra damage. To clear things up, this is not plus 7 attack, so you can't abuse that effect with Heavy Blade. Also, the 7 extra damage is true damage and is only added after all regular damage calculations, meaning you calculate everything like normal and then just add plus 7 to the total. Similar to Woe Dao, this plus 7 damage does work on area effect specials like Blazing Light, which Leif already has. Also, it's a bit odd, but Light Brand's extra damage is already included in the damage window preview. So if the enemy's defense is 5 higher than their resistance, you will see in the preview that the damage Leif deals is already including the plus 7 from the Light Brand. I can't confirm for myself, but apparently this can be misleading if you use specials like Glimmer or Astra, which calculate their bonus damage from the damage dealt to the enemy. Basically, these skills will not interact with Light Brand's 7 extra damage. Overall, I'd say this weapon is okay, since if you do proc its effect, that could be a potential 14 extra flat damage if Leif attacks twice. However, failing to meet its condition means it's basically a silver sword with a defense refinement. You have to depend on the enemy's stats, and that isn't something you have complete control over either. To go into some builds, you can use Light Brand in PvP, but I recommend you try to put Leif in a team that can debuff enemy resistance, whether it's Threaten Res, Res Ploy, or even the new Chill Res or Res Smoke skills. Add some dragons or mages who also benefit from lower enemy resistance, and Leif can have a pretty cool role in a team. For Arena, I would recommend focusing on Leif's high base speed stat, and you can increase it with skills like Fury or the Speed Sacred Seal. Desperation works great with Fury, and Leif has a pretty decent chance to proc it with some speed buffs. If you think the Light Brand isn't good enough, you can give Leif a Slaying Edge plus and refine it for defense or speed. You can then run his S-Strength B skill just for the lower cooldown at the start so that Leif can instantly charge a special move in his first round of combat. You're pretty free to run whatever you want. Bonfire with this combo means Leif will proc it after getting hit one time. You can also run the Quick and Pulse Sacred Seal and then use Ignis instead. This isn't a bad option if you have a minus speed Leif, but still want to use him in Arena. To take things further, give Leif some support with an Infantry Pulse ally, and that means you can have any 4-turn special charge at the first turn of a fight. This can work really well with an Area of Effect special if you can clean up the rest of the fight with your allies. I can see this being a fun build, and it's not insanely impossible to set up either. Now for PvE content, I think you want to keep S-Strength for its full heal every new battle. For modes like Tempest Trials or Chain Challenges, Leif can top off his health and get reduced special cooldown, which can be vital in these tough multi-round situations. With Ardent Sacrifice or Reciprocal Aid, Leif can heal his team if you know he isn't going to be fighting for the rest of that battle, and then he'll heal back up to full HP the next fight. I think S-Strength will be very, very good for Leif if they do add more continuous battle modes like Tempest Trials. In summary, Leif has a pretty competitive stat line for a fast infantry sword unit. 38 base speed is pretty great, and 32 attack is okay. He doesn't exactly have the same offensive power as Mia or Iroh, but that's mainly because the light brand just isn't as insane as the other two weapons are. It's an okay legendary weapon, but you have no control over its effects since it's only comparing the enemy stats. It can work in arena, but I think PvE content generally has units with more mismatched defense and resistance stats. As for S-Strength, it's not that great for arena unless you build around it. I do think it's one of the best PvE skills in the game, and it will do a lot of work in Tempest Trials type game modes. I'm pretty sure Leif will be a bonus unit in the upcoming Tempest Trials, so if you have him, I'd suggest using him to rack up those points. Overall, Leif can be built for different situations. He can run a high speed offense or a decent defense, but you will want to swap out some of his base skills based on what you want him to do. I also think you should build him separately for arena and PvE modes, since he can really shine in either one if you build him right. I do think Leif is a solid sword unit, but Sword Reinhardt's sheer craziness sort of casts a shadow over him. The light brand is an okay weapon, but Leif does have the stats to run other things like a slaying edge instead. S-Strength will be a hit or miss skill for some people, but again, Tempest Trials is coming soon, and I think Leif will be a really good unit for that game mode. That's it for this video, and I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have Leif, feel free to give your own thoughts on him. The new Grand Conquest event should have started by now, so don't forget to join in and earn some rewards. It's actually pretty crazy. So I'll see you guys in the next video.